Hello guys, what's up? I'm Surge Designer and today I want to talk about how we can create realistic renders in Enscape 3.5. So I use SketchUp 2022 and my rendering engine is the Enscape 3.5, so I'm gonna open it like that. As you can see, we have this type of 3D model in here. This side is nothing, just the textures, and we have the house in here. So I create some type of sand in my SketchUp, so I'm gonna click on it to reverse back on it, and it's a little bit high quality model and take some type of rips. So I'm gonna press F on my keyboard and I want to set my views to the view number 1 in here. Now it's good. I'm gonna close this option in here. So now I want to open the visual setting. I'm gonna reduce the rendering quality to the draft option. Now I want to click on the output, so I'm gonna change it to the custom resolution, and I'm gonna change it to some resolution about, for example, 1080 to the 920. Turn on the save frame in here, and now it's good. So let's get rendering. At first, I'm gonna start with the camera. Actually, as you can see, we set some camera with the 2-point perspective. I suggest that you always use 2-point perspective option for your realistic renders, because all of the lines and angles are visible in the picture and it's really good. So another option we have is the walk mode. I'm gonna switch it to the walk mode, or when I press F on my keyboard, I can change it to the fly mode like that. So at first, I'm gonna uncheck my camera. So I'm gonna click on the visual setting in here, drag it in this place. Now I want to focus on my model, but I don't know how, so I'm gonna choose the field of view in here and adjust it something like that. It is really nice and good, something like this, and I'm gonna adjust it to the 56 in here. Now I want to increase my eye height, so I'm gonna press F on my keyboard to edit my view. For this reason, if I change my Y position to the, for example, 3, as you can see, our height will be go much higher than the past. So I'm gonna change it to the 3.6 to have a little sky in our system, and now I'm gonna save it. Alright, now I'm gonna click on the visual setting again in here. And at first I'm going to check my clock. As you can see, when I adjust my sun, we have different type of suns in here near to the morning, for example 6 a.m. or something like that, 7 a.m. but I want some type of shiny, so I'm going to increase it to the 9 a.m. something like that. And now I want to come to the sky option in here. My source is the white ground, for example, and I don't have any clouds in my sky. I have some very clean sky in here like that, without any type of counter-radars or other things. In the atmosphere, I'm gonna reduce the fog option in here. About the sun position, I hold control on my keyboard and press U to reach some type of good rendering light. So I just only use sunlight, so I'm gonna reduce my time. So maybe something like that is not bad in here. For example, 6:24 a.m. and now I can change my sun position, something like that, much realistic than the past in here. And I think everything is good in here. I have my water pool with high quality of reflection. I'm gonna increase the sun brightness a little bit, for example 134, and night sky is not important in here. We have shadow sharpness, so focus on these places. As you can see, when I increase the shadow sharpness, I can see some type of high detail shadows, but it's not realistic because in the real world we don't have any type of shadows like that. So I'm gonna add 18 for it. We don't have any type of artificial light, but I can increase it to the 116, and the ambient brightness is about 66, something like that. Maybe it's a little bit too high. I can adjust it to the 59 in here. I don't have any type of wind on my screen, so I came back to my image setting. I'm not sure about the contrast, highlight, or the shadows. I can turn on the auto contrast to have better results in here. When I increase the saturation, my render is not realistic totally, so I'm gonna control it a little bit to the 98 or 100. We have cold temperature. Actually, I have some type of warm color temperature, so I can reduce it to the 1500 Kelvin, or I can change it to the 6000 Kelvin. We don't want to create animation, so I'm gonna turn off the motion blur in here. Sun is not in our position, so lens flare is not important at all. I'm gonna change it to the 44, and bloom is about 0 because I need some type of sharp rendering here. I can adjust my chromatic aberration to the 4 and increase the lens flare to the 66. And we have vignette in here. I have much brighter render, so I'm gonna adjust it to the 18. At the main window, I can change my mode to the white, for example. As you can see, we have this type of rendering here. And now I want to open the focus option and lens camera, so I'm going to turn off the autofocus and adjust my depth of field to the 20. As you can see, we have some type of blur rendering here, but we can adjust it very simple and easy by moving the focal point on our aim. As you can see, I can add some number about 11.33, and when I increase the depth of field, my other places in my lens will be blur, but it's not really realistic because we don't need this type of intensity for our blurness. So I'm going to reduce the depth of field to the 8% or something about 16. Not bad, it's good. So exposure is acceptable, but I want to re-exposure it again, or I can reduce the exposure, something like that. I came back to my image setting. In this place, I'm gonna reduce the lens flare to the 44 again. At the atmosphere, we have ambient cut, and I want to reduce the sun brightness because in these places we have a little bit highlight burn. So I'm gonna change it to the 119, and the sky is good, output is good. So I'm gonna render my first shot in here, very simple and easy. So I'm gonna increase my rendering quality to the ultra. As you can see, Enscape will reset your screen like that. As you can see, we have lots of differences in Enscape 3.5. actually, global animation called GI and some brightness calculation is improved. And now I want to render my image, so I'm gonna click on the screenshot in here and type my file name in the GPG format, for example white render, and press save. Alright, as you can see, the time of the rendering depends on your hardware accelerator. So I'm using Nvidia GTX 960 and it's not bad, it's good. But if you use RTX option, we have different type of new things in the Enscape. For example, when I open the general setting, I can turn on Nvidia denoiser and ray trace sun shadows and hardware accelerator ray tracing. It depends on your RTX graphic card. So I came back to my Enscape environment. Now I want to switch it to the color mode, so I'm gonna click on the none option in here, and it's really realistic than the past, so I don't need any type of outline in here. Now I just want to render my photo. As you can see, we have the reflection of the materials and facet of the building on our water pool. So I'm gonna click on the screenshot rendering, change it to the JPG, and I want to adjust my file name to the render max, for example, and click save. And I think it's really good than the past. So you can do lots of works with the Enscape 3.5 on your systems, and if you use Enscape 3.4, is good, like the new version, and Enscape is really wonderful. So I don't suggest some type of software, for example like Lumion, for low config systems, but you can create some basic realistic renders in the SketchUp plus Enscape, very simple and easy. So I need another shot from my render, but in the cloudy weather. So I'm gonna press F on my keyboard. I adjust my position like that, or maybe I came to this place is better, some type of thing for it like this. Now I want to create some view, so I'm gonna click on it, but for much better result I'm gonna come to the visual setting and reduce my rendering quality to the draft. So now I want to click on the create view. I don't want to save some position. The pitch is about 0, so I can adjust it 0 in here, and the yaw is about, for example, 236 or 240, as you can see, or some other numbers like 44. It's good now, and I'm gonna call it number 2 and create on the this image in here. So now I want to change some type of settings, like the camera position, as you can see, something like that. And I can open the visual setting in here. I want to reduce my field of view because I only want to show the building in here, something like that is really good, really nice. Alright, I'm gonna adjust it about 16 in here and change the field of view to the 38. That's good. The exposure is about 50, and I can adjust my depth of field to the building's edge like this, and I want to add 14.12 meter for my lens flare. And for the depth of field of the blurness, if I increase it to the 100, what happened? As you can see, all of the places beside of the lens shining system will be get blur and yield the blurness on your screen. But it's not realistic at all, because lens cameras always use some number between 0 to the 15 or 16. So I'm gonna add 16 in here. Now I want to come back to my image setting, atmosphere and sky. So in the sky I'm gonna increase the density of the clouds, something like that, about 56. And when I increase the cirrus amount, actually I will have some cloudy weather, but it's not really good and not in my mood or favorite. So I can change the variety of the clouds very simple and easy with this option. So I'm gonna adjust it to the 26, and about the latitude I can move my clouds like that, and you can create different type of animations with this option in here. So I add latitude to the 2700, but you can adjust it very simple and easy, for example something like this, 7726, and it's done. About the latitude I can change it like that. I want to have some reflection of the clouds on my windows, as you can see. So I'm gonna click on it and add 3.800 and press enter. So now I want to close this option and minimize my window in here, open the SketchUp. So I think it's really good, but we have some type of window in here. So I'm gonna open the material editor in Enscape and open the paint bucket in the SketchUp. If you use in this type of option, minimize it, Enscape at the right side and SketchUp in the left side, you can work much easier than the past. So I'm gonna select this glass in here, adjust the color of it like that, roughness is about 0, and when I increase the specular you can see the more details of the clouds on your window, and when I decrease it you can't see any type of cloud reflection on your window. So I'm going to increase it to the, for example, 76. And when I increase the opacity, I can only see the clouds or the GI, but when I decrease it, I will have much realistic results in here. So I'm going to type 10% for it. Reflective indisc or refractive indisc is related to the some type of things inside the house, but it's not working here. So I'm going to add one for it. Number one, and press enter. And about the tint color, I can adjust some color like the bisco, or change it to the blue, something like that. It's not bad for the some cartoony renders, but I suggest some color like the black for it. It's much realistic than the past, but you can use something like light gray. It's good. And it's transmated. Everything is done. Now I want to come back to my Enscape environment in here. I open my visual setting. So I can adjust a little bit outlines on my model, for example 6% in here. And depth of field is good, exposure is good, contrast is good, lens flare is good. And everything is good in here. I came back to my atmosphere. So when I reset it, I will have this type of region in here, and when I increase it, I have this option in here. I came back to my sky option. I can change the latitude, something like that, for much realistic results in here. We have some clouds in this place, and now it's much better than the past. So I click on the output, everything is good. And I think now we don't have anything in here. So I'm gonna increase the rendering to quality to the ultra. And now I want to render this frame very simple and easy. So 2-point perspective is active, and I want to call this render NO2. So I press save on my keyboard. As you can see, we create these type of special renders with Enscape 3.5 very simple and easy, I think under maybe 4 minutes with some easy adjustable items in the Enscape. So I hope you enjoyed this video. Like and subscribe, don't forget it, and I will come back with more tutorials at the next sessions. And goodbye.